What's up, everybody? Lemontore here. I'm here to talk about the PS5, the PS5 Digital Only, and the Xbox Series X and the Xbox Series S. And I'm here to talk about the price and the release date and much more. Before I do that, please leave a like and subscribe for more awesome videos. All right, let's start with the hardware on the PS5 and the Series X. You can see here it's kind of self-explanatory. The CPU on the Xbox Series X is just a little bit better, not by much, but just a little bit. But if you go to the GPU, you can see the Series X is shining right here. It got 12 teraflops versus the 10.28 on the PS5, which means the Xbox Series X will show a little bit better quality than the PS5. I'm not saying the PS5 will have a bad quality, I'm just saying it will look a little bit more beautiful on the Series X. And the memories are the same, it's 16 GB for both of them. The bandwidth is really fast, 448 GB on the PS5 and 560 GB on the Series X. The internal storage is a custom 825 GB SSD on the PS5, and what I've seen on some videos, they've tried out the PS5 SSD, and I can tell you this, it is amazingly fast. I mean, really fast. It's a bit faster than the Series X, and here's where the PS5 actually shines. The SSD is really fast, but the Series X also has a 1 TB NVMe SSD, which is also fast, so it's not like it's a slow SSD. So what we got from this is that the PS5 is a lot faster. The quality is not better than the Series X, but it is a lot faster, and the Series X, it will look more beautiful, not as fast, but it will be still fast. Both of them have 4K and Blu-ray drivers, and both of them have the SSD, which we're really excited for. So the thing is with the PS5 and Xbox Series X, which one to choose, you know, because they got different things to offer. Like the PS5 have, you know, a lot of exclusive games, which I can't tell you how much I want to play Ratchet and Clank or God of War and games like that, you know. That's where the PS5 shines. I hope they release God of War 2 or other games, but I've seen a lot of new games which will come out. One of them is Ratchet and Clank, which I'm really excited for. And the Xbox Series X, when it comes to games, they don't have that much exclusive games, but they have, you know, Gears of War, Forza, and Halo, which, by the way, I'm really excited for Halo. It's a shame that it's delayed until 2021, but I'm really excited for the game to play. I've seen the gameplay. It doesn't look that bad, but it's nice that they will make the game better because they needed the time because of the coronavirus. So here's the thing: the PlayStation has a lot of exclusive things, which makes it really awesome. But the Xbox Series X, when it comes to games, it has the Game Pass, which gives you a lot of good games for a small amount of money. And also, on the Game Pass, you can play on the PC, which is, you know, awesome. Because if you have a good PC, you can play a lot of Xbox games on the PC, which is nice. I know the PS5 also has that, but the Game Pass has more variables, a lot of more things to many more games to play, which is kind of fun. So I'm here to, we can talk about the Series S, because it recently came out and they showed us, and it was different. I wasn't expecting this, actually. I was expecting a little bit square box or something like that, but it looks really clean. I gotta tell you, it looks really clean. But here's the thing, the Series S is a little bit different from the Series X. Like the Series X has 12 teraflops, but the Xbox Series S is 4 teraflops, which is a lot, is a big, it's different, it's much less. But they got a lot of good things too. They just want to people to play the next gen games. This is why they released this console, because they want everybody to play the games on the next console for not that much money. And as you can see in this picture, it's a lot of different things. They've taken away a lot, but it's still a fast console. It's not bad. It's still got an SSD, which is really nice. The CPU is the same, which is awesome too. And yeah, the RAM is a little bit less, but it's cool. We're all right with that. But the performance here, the Xbox Series X is 4K, 60 FPS, and up to 120, and also 8K gaming. But the Series S is 1440p, 60 FPS, which is less, but also it's not that bad. It's really not bad. As long as I get to play on 60 FPS and not 30 FPS, because I'm done with 30 FPS. I usually play on my PC on 144 FPS, and you know, you can't go back to 30 FPS. You just can't. It's hard. As you already know, if you have a PC, so it's difficult for me. But where the Xbox X shines here is it got backwards compatibility with every game from the first console to 360 and the Xbox One. So does the S. And here's the problem with the PS5. Here's the biggest problem with the PS5 right now. It doesn't get backwards compatibility for PlayStation 1, 2, and 3, which is a really big bummer. I mean, come on, they should have done something about that, because yes, I know they remaster a lot of games and stuff like that, but there's also a lot of potential to play the old school games. You know, you just want to relive your childhood memories or childhood games, you know, and it's really a bummer. But the Series X got everything, every game, and they're gonna keep releasing the old games to the new console, which will be really nice, because they will, you know, we can play some games on 120 FPS, which is really amazing. So we're here to talk about the price of the consoles. So we can talk about the Series S first, which is confirmed. The confirmed price is $300, which is amazingly cheap. I mean, if you want to play the next gen consoles, console games, this is worth the money. But here's the problem: you won't be able to play the Xbox Series X exclusives, you know, something that you need more power for some games, and sometimes the Series X won't be able to provide that. And that's the problem with the Series S: you can't play the Xbox Series X exclusives, which sucks. But for the price, it's kind of amazing. It's still good. It's not that bad. And we're here to talk about the Series X. It's been rumored for $499. I mean, like $500, which is also cheap, because I bought my Series X, Xbox One X, for the same price. It's not, they give us so many good things, and I'm happy with it. I mean, for $500 and all that, and it got ray tracing and SSD, I'm happy. $500 is good, you know, because I paid more for my graphics card than the actual pricing. And what I've heard about the PS5 pricing, I also heard $500, but the one without disc, it's supposed to be $450 or $400. We don't know right now. These are just rumors. But the Series X and the Series S, the release date is confirmed for November 10th. And I'm really excited for that, because I will buy it as soon as I can. And I will try to buy the PS5 too, but they haven't shown any release dates. So they're playing a chicken game. The PS5 is just waiting for Xbox to show the launch date. And now they have, and so the PS5 won't be far away. And they will soon show. I believe they will release this the PS5 on November, but later. I mean, perhaps in the end. So let's see here. There isn't a lot more to talk about. This is all the information I've been getting. For more information about PS5, Xbox Series X, and other consoles or other games, if you subscribe to my channel, I will be gladly to make this a thing, because I'll do my best to give you all the all the content, all the information, all the leaks as good as I can. Well, that is it for today. Have a nice day, everybody. Thank you for listening.